Nearly 15 years ago, few could have predicted that Five Friends and a Panda would capture the hearts and attention of millions worldwide. But the dudes of Dude Perfect have done just that. Yet, even though they're household names and are known for their ridiculous stunts, not everyone knows the real guys, or the stunts that may not have gone according to plan. Number 1. The Bowling Trick Shot Controversy. For those of you who don't know, Dude Perfect is a multinational conglomerate company headquartered in Frisco, Texas, that features a bunch of friends who routinely perform wild stunts. The group got together while attending Texas A&M University and now form one of the most popular YouTube channels in the world with over 53 million subscribers. Content created by Dude Perfect predominantly consists of videos depicting various trick shots, stereotypes, and stunts, with the group regularly uploading battle videos with insane outcomes. But in their second bowling trick video specifically, we see the group pulling off some of the craziest bowling stunts ever caught on camera. While the group is known for not using visual effects to enhance their videos, some eagle-eyed fans have caught on to some of their tricks, most notably found in this video. At around 1 minute and 24 seconds into the trick shot video, you'll see the start of another trick shot seamlessly transition into frame without a hitch. But if you look closely at the precise time when the new bowler sets up the play, you'll see the picture change and reveal an edit that the comedy group inserted into their video. And in one of the frozen frames, you can even see the leg of a group member disappearing with no seeming explanation, proving that the video was obviously edited and altered. Also, if you focus on the pins in frame, you'll notice that one of the center pins starts to fade out and then vanish entirely from view. While this may not be as obvious for all viewers at the speed at which the video takes place, there's no question that something fishy took place that evening. It's one of the few times where Dude Perfect has been caught on camera, duping their audience into believing that a trick shot was successful when it most likely wasn't. Had the trick shot gone according to plan, there would have been no need to edit the video in such a strange fashion. Next up, balls don't always cooperate. Another great example of how some of Dude Perfect's trick shots can go wrong took place when the group released a compilation video in November of 2012. The video features the old Dude Perfect crew before they received their millions of dollars. And part of the reason why this compilation video is so popular and was so well received is because it contains a lot of the times where the group failed in their trick shot attempts. And what better way to start off this compilation with the group staring into the camera and introducing each member, right? Well, the team also decided to have Kobe Cotton spin a basketball through the entire dialogue, which turned out to be a lot trickier than initially expected. Fortunately for Dude Perfect, the ball just managed to slip towards the end of the dialogue, resulting in it being tossed in the air and caught, which actually looked professional enough, but was sadly ruined when the rest of the group members burst out laughing, saying, "I knew this was going to happen." As you might imagine, introductory videos don't always go according to plan, and this compilation video posted by Dude Perfect exemplifies this beautifully. Also, the roof ramp stunt. Another clip from that very same compilation video shows off the group's biggest trick shots that went horribly wrong. In the video, the audience is faced with a member of Dude Perfect skating down the tile roof of a home, which resembles a scene from one of the first blooper reels from the Tony Hawk video games, which the group has been quite adamant on paying homage to since the start of their channel. However, when Tyler Tony tried to channel his inner Hawkman himself and skate down the tiles of the roof, things didn't go quite according to plan. He proceeds to slide down the roof and attempts to ramp off the end and land safely on the grass below. Unfortunately, gravity was not on his side with this one, and overcome by speed, he forgets to lift up the lip of the board to ensure a flat surface to land on. This results in the board toppling downwards and forcing Tyler to fall forwards, with nothing but cold hard grass to break his fall. Unsurprisingly, this landing is less than graceful, with the force resulting in his body ricocheting off the ground and the whole team jumping to his aid. Luckily, he was able to avoid any serious injuries, and even went right back up to the top of the roof to try the stunt again. Though, whether or not he completed it successfully this time remains to be seen. Regardless, there's no doubt that the high-impact fall was not the result that Dude Perfect was hoping for, even if it did make for a pretty sweet blooper reel. Number 4. The roller ramp stunt. It goes without saying that the early Dude Perfect crew really liked ramps, which is clear from the old blooper video featured in previous stunts on this list, where the team ended up setting up a wooden pathway that ended in a small wooden ramp laid up against one of their four-wheelers. The goal of the stunt was for Garrett Hilbert to put on a pair of inline skates, go as fast as he can, and jump over the four-wheelers in what would have been a classic bit of content. The stunt didn't go as expected, however, as Hilbert ended up going a lot faster than projected and wiped out before even making it off the ramp, which is what you get get for oiling up the skates beforehand. Due to the crazy amount of speed Hilbert was coming in at, he found it difficult to deal with the transfer from the flat to inclined surface, resulting in him falling backwards and hard on his tailbone. The next 2 minutes of the clip saw Hilbert sitting as still as he could on the ramp, recovering before building up the courage to attempt the stunt again. And in the end, he did manage to land it, making the instance just a brief hiccup in his successful stunting career. Next, the basketball trick shot. Another memorable moment for Dude Perfect happened when Cody Jones attempted to switch a basketball around his back and make a shot while driving a four-wheeler towards the net. However, not many people got to see the devastation caused from his first failed attempt of this trick shot. Rather than committing to the backwards switch, Jones proceeded to hesitate, which caused him to throw off the timing required to perform the trick. However, he wasn't able to bring his hands around front and regain control of the four-wheeler in time, and as a result, ended up crashing directly into the basketball net, tearing it out of the ground and bringing filming to an abrupt end before the net could be properly resecured. And finally, who was Dude Perfect before the fame? Dude Perfect is now so big they have their own television show on CMT and are even sponsored by major companies like Nerf, Fiat, Pringles, and Bass Pro Shops. Plus, they even have their own headquarters/clubhouse/trick shot factory in Frisco, Texas. They've transformed themselves into one of the most successful brands to come from YouTube, but it all started as five college roommates hanging out in their backyard. Tyler Toney, or the bearded guy, is the team's leader, and he seems to be their Steph Curry. He's the dude on camera making the majority of the group's trick shots dating back to their first videos. After graduating high school, he started studying at Texas A&M and looking for some other Christian guys to develop a relationship with. He already knew Garrett Hilbert from the high school basketball team and soon met the twins, and Cody Jones, who were all looking for the same thing. They all moved into a house together and put a basketball hoop up in the backyard. When most college students aren't in class or studying, they're usually partying or exploring promiscuity. Since the dudes were all devout, that kind of stuff didn't appeal to them, and so they needed to find other ways to spend their time. That's when they started to bet sandwiches on whether or not one of them could sink outlandish basketball shots in their backyard. Tony sank a lot of them, and they decided to shoot a video over 2 afternoons. Their first YouTube video, Backyard Edition, was uploaded on April 8th, 2009, and within a week, it had over 100,000 views. Soon after, Good Morning America called up for an interview, and the crew knew that they were onto something. They continued to up the ante with various challenges from Tony's home and a summer camp called Sky Ranch. ESPN E60 also called the dudes and wanted to do a segment shortly after as well. According to Cody Jones, Tony had the idea to go big at Texas A&M's Kyle Field and make an impossible shot from the bleachers of the stadium. The shot was from the third deck down to the basketball hoop set on the football field's track, with the basketball traveling 3.9 seconds and banking into the hoop. The shot was recorded as the world's longest successful basketball shot at the time, launching Tony and Dude Perfect into internet superstardom. And with that, it wraps up the video. Thanks for watching.